this piece of wood on the bottom of the feeder here to keep it off the ground, helping keep it from rusting out. Yeah, this, it's galvanized. It's just, but I don't want it to rust any more than what it has. I did just set it on here before in the past. But I'm gonna mount it now. I'm gonna just screw it to it. Torx and two Phillips bits. I like using Torx better. You just have the holding power. Let me go take these two Phillips. Phillips bits. Go get some Torx. Here's Torx. See, now I got these two corners down. I don't have to worry about it shifting or moving while I'm doing it. This bit is super hot right now, but I've got gloves on. If you don't have you a good pair of gloves while you're working on your homestead, you need to. Now, I don't have to worry about that piece of wood moving out from underneath the feeder. Last year we strapped the water barrel to this little tree right here, and it did the job all year long. Didn't have any problem with the pigs coming up to it and pushing the barrel at all. Of course, the barrel's 55 gallons of water, so that weighs a pretty good substantial amount. I don't know if we're going to do that again this year. I'm leaving it up to Leah. I'm letting Leah decide where she wants to put the water and feeder at. So. This ain't moving this year. Perfect.